Sukkot 33:19. Give not thy son and wife, thy brother and friend, power over thee while thou livest. Okay? So if your people are hemmed up in the times to come, and Esau is giving them threats, talking about he's going to kill them, you don't give them power over you, man. Because at the end of the day, you know that everything comes around full circle. They'll be back in the kingdom. Everything that you lose on this side, it's already considered gain unto you in the kingdom, man. Okay? Because this life is temporary. So you shouldn't give anyone power over you, even in the face of death, man. If it comes to rejecting the Lord, you got to put the Lord first regardless, man. Regardless of what predicament Esau may put you or your loved ones in, man. Okay? Do not take that mark of the beast. As long as thou livest and hast breath in thee, give not thyself over to any. So don't give people power over you. You got to learn how to stand up for yourself. You got to have faith in the Lord on your own. Because if you're looking around to everybody else for answers, you're not going to find the answers. If you put too much of your hope and faith in your woman, you're not going to make it on the chariots, man. If you love your children so much to where you put them before the Lord, your children are going to be destroyed. So are you. Okay? Matthew 26 and verse 41. Matthew 26 and 41. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. So we have to pray that we don't get caught up in temptation. The body might have you give in and take that mark, man. But the spirit within you will have you fight against the mark. So then you'd be put in a dilemma. You know, what do you do in a situation like that? Okay? That's why it's important that we fast and pray. That's why it's important that we keep faith, man. Okay? Because a lot of us, you don't know how you're going to die. You just think everything's going to be the same every single day. Then when the Lord calls you and requires your life from you, you don't got nothing to say. You're speechless. Okay? Let me read this again. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. So we have to pray always that we don't fall into the clutches of temptation. Because temptation's everywhere, man. You don't want to be so weak to where a beautiful woman is thrown at you and she has a husband and you pop her, man. You don't want to fall into that temptation. You don't want to fall into the temptation of thinking ill thoughts of your brother because maybe he said something that rubbed you the wrong way. You don't want to fall into that. Okay, you want to pray. You want to remain solid. You want to remain grounded. Okay? Because if you don't have a foundation, you're unstable. Okay? And if you're unstable, you're most likely double-minded. In this truth, you got to be single-minded. You have to have your eye focused on what? On this truth. Does that mean you can't enjoy yourself from time to time? Go out, have some drinks, go out and deal with a woman or however many women you got? No. But the truth has to come first, man. Okay? Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Pull out that word temptation in the blue letter right there. Thank you. sure that when you're sent through any trial, you don't fall short. You want to make sure that when you're sent through a trial, that you pass. Okay? In Greek, trial proving the trial made of you by my bodily condition. Since condition served as the test, the love of Galatians toward Paul. The trial of man's stability. Infidelity, which means she wasn't faithful. In this truth, you want to have fidelity. You want to have faith, man. Because if we ain't got faith, we don't got nothing to stand by. That's all we got in this world is faith, man. Okay? Marie 4 says, an enticement to sin. So you want to make sure you don't fall into temptation or you don't want to fall into any enticement that will draw you to sin. You want to make sure you're stable. You want to make sure you're grounded. You want to make sure that you're firm. Okay? Of the temptation by which the devil sought to divert Jesus, the Messiah, from his divine errand. Of the condition of things or a mental state by which we are enticed to sin, or to a lapse from the faithless in holiness, adversity, affliction, trouble. So when you're facing adversity, affliction, or trouble, you have to make sure, to the best of your ability, that you're built up enough to get through it. You don't want to fall into the hands of sin, okay? Because sin is like a sniper trying to knock you off from a building, man. You don't know which way it's coming from. You just walk it in one day, boom, you out of there, man. So in this path, you want to, you know, keep your eye on things. Because a lot of these people out here, they don't know the truth. A lot of these people out here also, they're enemies of the truth. You have a lot of spies and agents out here. You have people who take pictures and send our pictures in. So, you know, knowing these things, it doesn't mean you should get scared, but it's just more proof on why you need to pray. It's more proof that you have to stay focused. You have to stay focused, okay? Sirach 21 and 2. Flee from sin as from the face of a serpent. If you were to see a serpent, are you going to try to pet it? No, you're not. Especially if you were Jake raised up here in America. If you saw a snake come from somewhere, you're not going to try to run close to it. You're going to try to run away from it. And that's how you have to treat sin. Because sin is like a poisonous snake, man. Once it bites you, you slowly start to die, man. That's why for a lot of people who don't have Yahweh Shai, they've been bit by that serpent, and they're just dying out with no mercy, no savior, man, with no hope. This world doesn't have hope, man. But our hope is in Yahweh Vashem Yahweh Shai. The things that you people hope in is that somebody come up here and remove us from off the streets. Okay? Sirach 21 and 2. Flee from sin as from the face of a serpent. So you gotta flee from sin like you saw a snake. If you see a snake, you don't run up to pet it. You get far away from it. That's how you have to treat sin. But a lot of people in this world, they're consumed in sin. Sin is all the way past their head. Okay? And they think that they can just fight this battle on their own. You have a lot of hard-headed Israelites who feel like they don't need the Lord, okay? But that's to their own demise, okay? if thou comest too near it, it will bite thee. The teeth thereof are as the teeth of a lion, slaying the souls of men. So the teeth of this serpent is like the teeth of a lion. The scriptures also tell you how the devil is as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. So with knowing that, you would have to be on your toes. You have to be aware. Because this world is totally anti-Yahweh Shai. This world don't care about our Lord, man. But it's all right, though, because the Lord's about to be exalted in this lifetime. And this kingdom is going to be destroyed. And the Lord's going to be exalted, man. Anybody who had anything bad to say who didn't believe, so what, man? You can't stop the prophecies. You can't stop the mind of the Lord, okay? Jump to the book of Ephesians. Ephesians 5 and 15. See then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. So you want to flee from sin like you fled from a serpent. So going back into the RFID chip. When the time comes that RFID chip is implemented, if you're able, you want to flee as far away as possible to get away from Esau, man. You don't want to be nowhere around Esau in them days. Because Esau's goal is to chip the majority of these people. And it's funny because the majority of these people, I don't even know who they are, but I know the majority of them are going to die. They're here today, but they're going to be dead soon, man. Because they don't follow the Lord. You got people out here smoking cigarettes. You got people out here rolling around with a woman that's not even theirs. Okay, you got heathens looking down on Israel. You got a lot of wickedness going on out here, man. And a lot of you people just assume like, you know, life's just gonna keep going on and everything's gonna be okay. That's not the case, man. You better be aware and smell the coffee, man. Because we're in the final hours, man, of this kingdom. And with knowing that, the so-called white man Esau gonna roll on you, man. He gonna roll on us. Because the reason, he knows that he has a short time to rule. Okay? This is Ephesians 5 and 15. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. So I want to get that word circumspectly in the blue letter. Give me a second. The word circumspectly in the blue letter, Greek 196, it says, it's pronounced in the Greek, akribos. And it means exactly, accurately, diligently, okay? So you want to accurately, or you want to diligently be circumspect. Just like when you have something that's a circumference, like a circle, being circumspect, you want to look around like a circle. A circle is something that's round. So to be circumspect, you're observing the things around you. Okay? Also, just like my glasses, another way of saying glasses is spectacles. So circum, or circumference, and inspect, which goes to spectacles, circumference, spectacles, circumspect. Look around, pay attention, okay? Don't be naive, man. Don't think everything is okay. Be aware of your enemies. Know who your enemy is. Don't follow after the ways of this world. Keep your enemies far away from you as possible, man. Okay? All right, I'll close up the blue letter now.